can we diagonalize every square matrix A? Okay, we may have complex eigenvalues, so in that case, a matrix will not be real diagonalizable. But suppose we do not have complex eigenvalues. Is every n by n matrix with only real eigenvalues, so n real eigenvalues, diagonalizable? Unfortunately, it's not that easy. We cannot diagonalize all matrices. We also need enough independent eigenvectors. We do have, though, an easy criterion to establish whether a matrix is diagonalizable or not. And this criterion uses the geometric multiplicity. In this video, you will learn this criterion, which will allow you to determine beforehand whether a matrix is diagonalizable or not. So let's look at four examples for matrices A1, A2, A3 and A4. So what we need to make D, so we need to have enough eigenvalues for our matrix D, and we need to make an invertible matrix P. P has to be invertible, so its columns need to be independent, so we need enough independent eigenvectors. Let's see what happens in those four examples. Well, we know from a previous example, A1 had two different real eigenvalues, 0 and 5. Well, both eigenvalues have at least one independent eigenvector. In this case, we found minus 2, 1 and 1, 2. So we could find our D and we could find our P. In this case, this matrix was diagonalizable. Now, let's continue with A2. If we compute P lambda equals the determinant of A2 minus lambda times I2, we get lambda squared plus 1. Well, the eigenvalues are the zeros of the characteristic polynomial. And this polynomial has no zeros, well, it has no real zeros. So here we get stuck immediately. A2 is not diagonalizable because we don't even have real eigenvalues. Let's continue with matrix A3. There we see we have a lambda equals 2, with algebraic multiplicity 2. Well, you can see this from the characteristic polynomial, for example. So we have two real eigenvalues, 2 and 2. Now, second problem, do we have enough independent eigenvectors? So we compute A3 times A3 minus lambda times I2, which is a zero matrix. So we have to find a null space of this matrix. And we see that the basis of this null space is just E1 and E2, for example. So in this case, we have two independent eigenvectors, E1 and E2, for example. Or you can take other choices. So we have two eigenvalues, two independent eigenvectors. So this matrix A3 is diagonalizable. Let us now look at A4. It's almost the same, only this element over here is different. And it causes some trouble, as you will see. Again, lambda equals 2 is the only eigenvalue, with algebraic multiplicity 2. What happens if we compute A minus lambda times I2? We get almost a zero matrix, only this element 1 over here is the difference. And if we solve the problem A minus lambda times I2 times vector x equals 0, we have the augmented matrix over here. We solve it. We see that C1 has no pivot, so it is free, and we get 1 times C2 equals 0, so C2 equals 0. So the solution will be C1, C2 equals, well, C2 equals 0, C1 is free, so C1 times 1, 0. So the basis for the eigenspace will be now the set consisting of only E1. So in this case, we have only one independent eigenvector, so that means it's not enough, we need two, because we have a 2x2 matrix. So this A4 is not diagonalizable. Now, let us look at the criterion. First of all, we know that the sum of algebraic multiplicities of all eigenvalues is at most n. If you form the characteristic polynomial of an n by n matrix, you have a polynomial of degree n. This polynomial has exactly n zeros, so exactly n eigenvalues, if you include complex eigenvalues. So you have either n real eigenvalues, so you have enough of them, or you have some real and complex eigenvalues, but then you have less eigenvalues and you don't have enough. So the sum of all algebraic multiplicities will be either n or less. What we have also seen before is that the geometric multiplicity of every eigenvalue is smaller or equal than the algebraic multiplicity. So if you take your different eigenvalues, you look at the corresponding eigenvectors, then the total number of independent eigenvectors will be the sum of your geometric multiplicities. Well, the geometric multiplicities are all less or equal than the algebraic multiplicities, so if you add them up, then the sum of all geometric multiplicities will also be less or equal to the sum of all algebraic multiplicities. So the sum of the geometric multiplicities will be at most n, but if you want to be diagonalizable, your sum of geometric multiplicities has to be n, because you need n independent eigenvectors. So when can you diagonalize a matrix? Well, first of all, one, all eigenvalues need to be real. That's an easy one, because otherwise you just don't have enough eigenvalues. Now, what about the eigenvectors? Well, the sum of all geometric multiplicities is at most n. It has to be equal to n. So you have to be at the maximum. That means that all geometric multiplicity of all eigenvalues has to equal the algebraic multiplicity. If only one eigenvalue has a lower geometric multiplicity than algebraic multiplicity, then the sum of all geometric multiplicities will never be n again. It will always be less than n. So if all geometric multiplicities need to be equal to the algebraic multiplicities, but then you are done, because the eigenvectors from different eigenvalues are independent. So if all geometric multiplicities are the same as all algebraic multiplicities, then the sum of your geometric multiplicities will be n, and then you will have n independent eigenvectors, and then you can diagonalize your matrix. So we have two criteria here which tell you whether your matrix is diagonalizable or not. And let's see in the next video how we can apply that in a specific and explicit example.